It was published in a peer-reviewed scientific journal, and we know that means it's right. Well, 2 weeks go by, and far less fanfare, far less repetition on social media, no tweets about the correction from Catherine McKenna. But look at this story. Climate contrarian uncovers scientific error, upends major ocean warming study. And this is not from some obscure newspaper, it's from the San Diego Union Tribune, and you'll see why this is the San Diego paper. Let me read the first couple of sentences from this one. Researchers with UC San Diego's Scripps Institution of Oceanography, so it was the San Diego University that made the error, and Princeton University recently walked back scientific findings published last month that showed oceans have been heating up dramatically faster than previously thought as a result of climate change. I'll just skip ahead. The conclusion came under scrutiny after mathematician Nick Lewis, a critic of the scientific consensus around human-induced warming, posted a critique of the paper. And I'll just skip ahead. Co-author Ralph Keeling took full blame and thanked Lewis for alerting him to the mistake. When we were confronted with his insight, it became immediately clear there was an issue here, he said. We're grateful to have it pointed out so quickly that we could correct it quickly. Well, fancy that. Now, I know you heard the report of the first one because it was everywhere. I don't listen to talk radio. I don't listen to news radio. I get too much news in my life. I only listen to music on the radio. But even the music stations were breaking in with this horrific Halloween news of the world is burning up, according to this University of California at San Diego study. I can assure you it wasn't until today that I learned about the correction through my friend Mark Morano, the boss of Climate Depot, who joins us now via Skype. Mark, the only surprise here is that the climate scientist who got it wrong was actually slightly magnanimous to the skeptic who pointed it out. I found that surprising. Normally they just call them names like bigot or dinosaur. What's completely unsurprising to me is that another fear-mongering study has been debunked and that the retraction got 0.1% of the ink of the allegation. That's what's not surprising.
Well, a couple things here. Yes, this study, as you mentioned, the Halloween scare study. Let's first talk about how this was portrayed. New York Times, Associated Press, The Washington Post, international media. The ocean's warming faster than we thought. Worst case scenarios exceeded. Oceans now warming 60% faster. A new study in the prestigious peer-reviewed journal Nature. They always act as though this is like, you know, this is the gold standard and then nothing can happen. And then it literally took Ezra, Nicholas Lewis is a climate skeptic. He's a mathematician. Now, people will say, oh, he's not a climate scientist. First of all, climate science covers many disciplines, geology, astrology, oceanography, chemistry, and most important, one of the most important, statistics and mathematician.
Now, you said astrology. I want to interrupt you. You said astrology. I know you mean astronomy, but it is more, it's closer to astrology, isn't it? These days in astronomy. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you. I think you inadvertently made a pun there, and it was funny. I interrupted you. Keep going, Mark.
No, absolutely. Astronomy. I don't want to insult
it's
the
both.
Astronomy.
It's got both. Keep going.
Well, what the results are akin to astrology when they try to blame every bad weather event on climate. So what happened here was that a mathematician took a look at this, and it's not even an exaggeration to say within an hour or two of looking at this study, it didn't seem right. He found a major underlying math error that changed the 60% plus warming worse than we thought of oceans to absolutely nothing to see here, just another study. And their claims all became within the margin of error, within the uncertainty bands. In other words, there was nothing to see here. Move right along, folks. But as you mentioned, Ezra, the retraction got in the Washington Post. It probably did the most hilarious job. They mentioned the paper. It was a mistake. And it's probably going to end up being withdrawn or a massive correction to just totally neuterize it. But the Washington Post spent most of their article talking about how the consensus on climate is strong and that this one study going down means nothing and blah, blah, blah. And it's just a fascinating exercise in how the claims, when they're discredited, the media doesn't like to play up. And this is another example that's perfect that it was on Halloween.
That's an excerpt from my daily show, The Ezra Levant Show, weekdays at 8 p.m. Eastern. Every day I do a monologue, interview a guest, and read my fan mail and my hate mail. To subscribe, go to therebel.media/shows.